Canada, Russia, the semifinal of the World Junior in front of a capacity crowd on a Saturday night. What more could you ask for? There have been so many close calls in this four-in-a-row streak for Canada.
What do you remember about Drive for Five?
That was the slogan, you know, and anytime you go into a tournament, and being in your home country, there's a lot more pressure on you.
And once again, these two rivals meet in the medal round in a single elimination game. Hodgson walks in, he shoots, it goes off a leg, drops down, Everly shoots, score!
And watch how fortuitous this bounce is for Everly.
Right off the skate.
I remember the game being very back and forth. They'd score, then we'd score, then they'd score, and then we'd score. And then they'd always seem to score after and just kind of be up at the end.
Golubev got a piece of that. Tokarski down. They jam away. A touch to lose. They score! Popov got the last touch, and the Russians lead for the first time with 2:20 to go in the third period.
You guys are down 5-4. Are you nervous at that point?
I don't think you're nervous in those situations. You know, you want to be the people that are on the ice. You want to be the guy that, you know, has the chance to get your team back in the game.
And Tokarski will remain on the Canadian bench. Feeds that in front, a loose puck. Tavares reaches for it. Now Klopov with a chance, shoots, and he misses the empty net. Icing against the Russians, 41.3 seconds to go.
They missed, and I remember looking over at one point, and they were kind of laughing. You could tell they thought that they had it wrapped up.
20 seconds to go in the third. Hodgson. Filatov picks it up. Filatov with time to the line. Ellis.
You're anticipating that he keeps it in and comes back low.
Ellis in there as well. Voychuk looking for it. Tavares pulls it out.
Trying to get as much urgency as you can because you know the clock's winding down. Kulikov, he kind of misplayed it as far as catching it. Kind of popped right to me.
Tavares backhand towards the goal. Loose puck. Everybody scores! Tie game! Can you believe it?
How much time was left on the clock when you scored?
5.4 seconds left.
If I went to an ATM and punched in 5-4, 5-4, would I have punched in your pin?
No.
And this game is going to a shootout. Jordan Eberle starts the shootout. Eberle in score! John Tavares can give Canada a two-goal lead in the shootout. Tavares in, scores! Chernev in on Tokarski, stop! Canada wins! Canada's going to the gold medal game!
As an 18-year-old kid, you're playing in the capital of the country in a tournament that I've watched every year since I was 5 years old. Yeah, it's a surreal moment.
Are you comfortable that that goal might be the most celebrated thing you ever do?
You know what, it's tough to say.
Backhand try, Jordan Eberle scores!
You know, you're always searching for something better. And I hope to be remembered for the person who scored the Stanley Cup goal one day, you know.
You get here and Tavares is still here. You start talking about that play.
Oh, of course, yeah. You know, anytime you win with guys, you always just create a bond, and you know, we have that. I think they always joke around with me about that play and how often they see it, and they're getting sick of seeing it, but you know, it's all in good fun. It's an important part of my life, and I look back on it with obviously a lot of fond memories.